Hey guys, when using the groupby method in pandas, you should avoid one big mistake. To explain the mistake, let me walk you through an example. Here in my Excel file, I have some financial data for a business. The total sales are 17 million USD. Let us now convert this spreadsheet data into a pandas data frame to perform some analysis. To do so, I'm using the My Toolbelt add-in. You can find the link to this add-in also in the description box. Once I select the data and insert a title, we will have a new Jupyter notebook in the workbooks directory. Let me spin up this notebook to check out our data frame. After executing the first two cells, I will print out the data frame head. As we can see, we now have the same data as in the spreadsheet. And we will see our 17 million USD again when I sum up the sales. As the next step, let me group the sales by segment. After executing this cell, our data frame looks like this. So far, so good. And to validate that everything is working as expected, let me sum up the sales again. Okay, great, we still have our 17 million. Next, let me also group the data by segment and product. When I run this cell, we will get back the following data frame. And also on this new data frame, let me sum up the sales. Whoops, now we have only 15.8 million of sales. So, what is the issue here? The issue is caused by the missing values. By default, pandas will drop any missing values when using the groupby function. To avoid this, you can set dropNA to false. When I rerun the cell, we will see our 17 million again. So, when I print out the data frame and scroll down a bit, I can see that some of the product names in the government segment were missing. Therefore, before you group your data frame, ensure that you take care of any missing values. To find out if you have missing values in your data frame, you can use isNA and then sum up all the Boolean values. Pandas will then return an overview with all missing values by column. In my case, I have two missing products. Another tip is to calculate the missing values in percentage. For this, you just need to take the mean of isNA and multiply the result by 100. And now you can see that the column product includes 1.9% of missing values. Okay guys, I hope this quick tip was helpful to you. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.